Now that we are done with the pre-analysis, let's get into answers. And as we are going through answers, I'll relate what we are doing to what we saw in pre-analysis about the underlying theory. And that's very important to move beyond button pushing and start thinking like an expert. I originally recorded the geometry steps for this module in Design Modeler, which is a legacy geometry engine. Now there's a new geometry engine, Space Claim, and all the development is going to take place in Space Claim. So I'm re-recording the geometry steps in Space Claim in these videos. And as I'm doing that, I'll use the current version, which is 19.1, even though the meshing videos and model setup videos, etc., which I've already done, are in 17.1. And if there are any changes from 17.1 to the current version, we will make a note of it either within the video or alongside the video. I strongly believe that the best way to learn simulations and engineering problem solving using simulations is to actually get into software like Answers that professionals use and solve lots of different problems under the guidance of a coach, which is my role here. So the strong benefit of doing that, and that's quite different from how faculty normally teach. So I'm kind of out there. However, the challenge is that the answers versions can change, and so when I've done something in a previous version and you'll do something slightly different in the new version, we have to kind of account for that. And fortunately, the changes are relatively minor between versions, and so we are trying our best to put in kind of text in the videos or alongside the videos to indicate that. That's something to keep in mind as you see these, version inconsistencies. So we need to draw our undeformed midline in Answers, and we'll do that in Space Claim, and then later we'll ask the solver to find the deformed shape of the midline such that the potential energy is minimized. Let's start Answers workbench. So I'll go into the search space here and start typing in workbench. And you see I have 18.2 and 19.1. I've two versions here. You can run multiple versions side by side. I'll use the current version, and you may get firewall warnings, which you can cancel out of. I'll maximize this, and I will go under Analysis Systems and drag Static Structural into the project page. And in the process, I'm giving it a very important clue about the mathematical model, more on that later. And I will give a suitable name for this project, which I will call Euler Bernoulli Model of Beam. And enter. We will come to engineering data later when we are specifying the we are completing the specification of the mathematical model. So let's go to geometry, right-click on geometry, and you see there is there's Space Claim. You can do it using Space Claim or the legacy geometry engine design modeler. I'll use Space Claim here. Once Space Claim comes up, let's set the units, which we want it to be meters. Our midline is 4 meters long, so I'll say File, Space Claim Options, and I'll go under Units and set the length to meters. And I also found that it's good to set the minor grid spacing to something larger than the default. So I'll increase it by 2 orders of magnitude, 0.1, and which is more comparable to the length, which is 4 meters. So I'll say OK, and then I will select my sketch plane. I'll click here, and then I will go as if I'm selecting the XY plane towards the upper right, i.e. the back. And then I'll say look at plane. Okay, so you should be looking at the XY plane. And then I'll go and under the sketch tools, I'll select line. And I want to start at the origin, and so I should see snapping to co-center here. So for that, I need to zoom in, I did that using the middle mouse wheel. And so now I see snapping to curve center over here. So once I see that, I'll start drawing the horizontal line and then click on the space bar and enter the length of our undeformed neutral axis. Okay, 4 meters, and I will click escape to get out of the line tool. You might have to do that, you know, 2 or 3 times. And let's give it a name for the component. So I'll come to design over here in the structure, right click and say new component, and I'll call it line body to be consistent with the name that design modeler used to use. Hit enter, and I'll move that the curve that we just created on the line body. Now this doesn't design modeler, you know, that name got transferred to Ansys Mechanical for meshing, etc. This with space claim, this is actually called beam when you transfer it to mechanical. So you'll see some, you know, inconsistencies in nomenclature between my previous videos in 17.1 and what you'll see here. I think you can figure it out. Now, space claim, so if I come here, it says curves, which means that it thinks that this line here, which that I've drawn, is something I'm using to create a 3D solid object, which is not what I want to do. I want to use it to, you know, create the midline of my beam, and for that I need to do something extra. So let's do that. And before that, I will go and I will say file, save. I will go to an appropriate folder, and actually, you know, I'll cancel out of here, and I'll do the save within Workbench. Otherwise, it'll just save it in the space claim format. So I'll go to Workbench window, and I'll say file save, and go to the appropriate folder, and I'll just call it beam. And if I go to the folder, I'll see I have this WBPJ file and the and an associated folder, and this backup will go away when I exit the project. And you need both of these to retrieve the project. I've seen students tripping up by not saving this folder, so keep that in mind. And there's also a different way of saving it using the WBPZ format, which is convenient for emailing, etc., which I cover under the geometry step in conduction. So we'll put a link to it on the page in which this video is embedded. Okay, so next we will tell space claim that, hey, this is actually the midline of a beam. It's not, and the line is not being used to create a 3D solid.